CEO here in WVU Medicine, Princeton. Thank you, Karen, for hosting us today. Rusty Sarver is our board chair at Princeton. Rusty, thank you for your leadership. Tom Haywood is a member of our board of directors of our health system. Thank you, Tom, for being here today. David Hess is one of our great CEO physician leaders out of United Hospital Center in Bridgeport. Thank you, Dr. Hess, for being here. And Dr. Tom Takubo is our executive vice president of provider relations, and a lot of what happened today is because of Tom's leadership working in his role as head. So thank you, Dr. Takubo, for being here. And others, thank you, everyone, for being here. So our goal at WVU Medicine is to improve the health trajectory of the state of West Virginia. You know, and over the last 20 years and last decade, we've really built a healthcare system headquartered out of our flagship in Morgantown, but with a footprint that goes literally from Martinsburg in the east to Parkersburg in the west, Wheeling up north, and now here in Princeton in the south. And our goal is to improve the health trajectory of the state. And we do that relentlessly. We're very proud of the work we're accomplishing and taking care of folks all around the state. But we've decided, we've been talking over the last couple years, we need to do more in oncology and cancer. And some of my colleagues today are going to talk about some of the challenges we have with cancer in the state. So we've decided to pursue NCI, National Cancer Institute Designation, for the WVU Cancer Institute, which is really the gold standard for cancer programs. And it's bestowed upon the nation's top cancer centers in recognition of their innovative research and leading edge treatments. And we will develop the Cancer Institute even more fully than it is today in the same way, where we will be headquartered in Morgantown, with all of our surgical imaging, you know, capabilities. And at some point, we're going to build a new cancer hospital in Morgantown, but it will be infused throughout the state in all of our cancer institute sites we have, in all of those places I talked about earlier, and all of the other places we're at, which will allow us to make sure that our research, our education, our cancer screening is happening throughout the states and throughout the state, and that everyone has access to spectacular care and the same clinical trials that you would have available if you were in Morgantown or any major cancer center. So why are we here in Princeton today? You know, Princeton, we actually, our board of directors just approved a $15 million expansion, which is primarily around the building out of the Cancer Institute here to be the southern hub of the Cancer Institute in the state. And Karen Bowling told me all of the floors where we're moving stuff, but it'll essentially be a brand new infusion center, all of our offices, clinical care. You know, at some point we'll move radiation oncology onto this campus and have a full branch of the Cancer Institute here. And we are blessed. The West Virginia Legislature was great in supporting what's bringing us here today, and our great governor, Governor Justice, was exceptionally supportive as we talked about our vision for the Cancer Institute and our vision to become an NCI designated center. So it is my honor and privilege to introduce the governor of the great state of West Virginia, Governor Justice.
Well, we thank you, and you know, I look around the room, and you know, whether it be Dr. Chandler or Karen or Tom or Gordon or you know Clay, just so many friends, and I know I'm gonna miss a bunch of you. Well, I just missed you, you know, but I mean this from the very bottom of my heart. Cancer, you know, is such an incredible, debilitating, you know, diagnosis, and all of a sudden, you know, someone says, you know, I really hate to tell you this, but you've got cancer. And for those of us that grew up in kind of the backwoods of this state, you know, it's almost like you just drop your head and hope just leaves you. But it doesn't need to be that. It really doesn't need to be that. Now, unfortunately, still, we have a lot of research and things to do that can some way, somehow, stop this dreaded killer. But there has been so many advances, and there's been so much absolute greatness that's come out of WVU, it's off the chart. There's all kinds of greatness that's coming out of you right here all the time. All the great people that work here, all the good stuff that happens, on and on and on. Now, this step will be the beginning of absolute major progress in this state. This is absolutely what we should be doing. You know, without any question whatsoever, the research, the great work that is being done in this state, whether it be at WVU or here, we need another big boost, don't we? We do. We need to step up. And we need to say, all those that are out there that do have a bad diagnosis, all of those are worth it. We're worth it. We really are. And so, all I can say is, this was a no-brainer to me. I'm absolutely on board. You know, I can tell you that that rascal right there, you know, Dr. Kubo, absolutely spearheaded this effort in lots of ways. You know, sometimes things are difficult in Charleston land, and I'm talking about in Charleston land, and you need a driver. And many, many, all the folks here, yeah, they get all kinds of kudos. But at the end of the day, we needed a driver. And so, Doc, you know, you don't know how much I appreciate you, and you don't know how much really and truly all the great people of this state will appreciate you for decades and decades and decades to come. The last thing I would say, the thing that is the most disturbing, and, you know, my executive assistant, Pam Rhodes, is with me today. She's not with me much and everything, but she was with me today. And I said, Pam, have you been where Baby Dog has been with me very often? She said, recently, she said, I haven't. I said, you watch this. So we walk in the front door, and everybody's going crazy, taking pictures and saying, oh, there's Baby Dog, there's Baby Dog. And not a single person says, there's the governor. I'm okay with that. Because you see, I've got a great sense of humor, and really and truly, not only that, I really believe that God gave every single one of you the ability to smile and to laugh. And this journey's tough enough. That's all there is to it. Now, if I can give you some real life wisdom, I would say you best better know how to smile and laugh a lot, because every single day this journey just gets tougher as you go. Now, the one thing that I promise you that she does, she makes you smile. And the other thing she does is she loves everybody. And it doesn't matter who you are. She loves everybody. And in my world, I don't know how it gets any simpler than just that. If we could just carry that through our lives, and we could make others smile, and we could love everybody, wouldn't it be one whale of a lot better world? And so, at the end of the day, I've had the great privilege to work with WVU. You know, Dr. Marsh has been my right hand, right hand, right hand, right hand, and it has been an unbelievable privilege to fly with you, sir. And that's all there is to it. And I love this rascal right here beyond good sense, too. And I mean this, my bud, and this one, too. But nevertheless, I thank you. Now, I've got a little something to give you. but and maybe this is worthwhile, but I've got $50 million here. Get up here. Listen, we got to some way keep baby dog in this picture here. You come up this way, I'll stand right here. Now she is very, very interested in chicken nuggets right now, y'all. Nevertheless, thank y'all so much.
I'm just going to stand right here, if that's all right. First of all, baby dog, thanks for bringing the governor. We're really, really, really grateful for that, as a matter of fact. He's also the governor's campaign chairman. This guy looks like a senator to me, don't you think? I think he does. Give him a round of applause. You know, Governor, I'm really privileged to work with you. You and I have been working together now for 6 years. And in that time, I can tell you, and the visionary leader over here, Albert, the other visionary leader, Dr. Marsh, but without your help, we would not have built a health system that I think is now really recognized as one of the most innovative health systems in the country. And the reason for that is, and I want to acknowledge this, the reason for that is the fact that we made a determination, thanks to our governor, that what we would do is we would build a system that would be helpful to everyone. You don't have to come to just one place. And with Karen here, with what we're doing now, what we're going to be doing in Welch, a number of other places, and the people of West Virginia for too long have had health deserts. And now they have health opportunity. And our future is based upon a great health system. You know, if we have healthy people, then we're going to have a healthy economy, we're going to have healthy education, and we're going to have ability to be able to grow. And for the first time in 2 decades, our population is growing, which I think is something to take credit in. And also, I'll just say something to you, Governor. I just saw data. West Virginia ranks 4th in the country in terms of economic growth right now. So, I know I sound like your campaign chairman, I am, but here we go. I think it's important to note that there's been such progress made here. Dr. Ellington, right there, who is the chair of our House Education Committee, and Dr. Ellington does a wonderful job in focusing on education. I really appreciate it. Senator Spoke, from my favorite people, and I just want to acknowledge that. Of course, Tom, the Senator Takubo, he was a tuition-paying father. And for that, we are very grateful. And I wish we had more children. We could use them, as a matter of fact. And then for everyone else, this is a great day for our state. $50 million, thanks to you. But this is not $50 million that we're just going to put in a pocket. We're going to build a center of excellence so that every West Virginian gets good. And I think that is so important. My wife died of breast cancer when my daughter was 15. It had the most incredible impact on my life. Lost the love of my life, and I was left both being mother and father. It's a hell of a lot harder, more difficult to be a mother, I might know. But you know, it really inspired me to think about how we every day can make a difference in people. Governor, that's what you're doing. Tom, that's what you're doing. Albert, that's what you're doing. So we're grateful for the support, but we're grateful for the fact that everyone in this room will have access to great health care. And cancer, we're going to discover the cure for cancer. But it's not going to be published in, we're not going to publish it in the New England Journal of Medicine or in Lancet. We're going to make sure that the people in Princeton, Weld, Bluefield have access to it. That's the West Virginia promise. So everyone, thank you for being here today. We really appreciate it.
I came to WVU Medicine in 2014, right about the time of my great partner that I have the privilege of introducing now. Dr. Clay Marsh is one of the most brilliant physicians, scientists, thought leaders, that I've ever had a chance to work with. And I think we're very blessed here in West Virginia and at the university to have Clay be a part of our great venture forward. So, Dr. Marsh, thanks for being here today.
Well, without going through and repeating what's been said, I think today is really about leadership. And certainly the governor's leadership for our state and his care and concern for the health of every citizen, Dr. Jacobo's leadership, our legislative leaders' leadership, certainly Karen, your leadership here, and David at UHC, and certainly Tom Haywood, and Hannah Hazard, and Albert, and Gordon. It is an amazing day to be a Mountaineer and to be part of this great state. But I'd like to focus my comments a little differently. So we have, in each of our bodies, 100 trillion cells. 100 trillion cells. Every day, 330 billion cells in our bodies are replaced. And our bodies replace most all of our cells in about a 7 to 10 year period of time. So the coordination between how many cells we have, how many cells move through our system each day, really gives us the setup for cancer. Because cancer is really the situation where our own cells are not accurately removed from our body that should be removed, or that gain certain selective advantages in the ability to grow, and the ability to stay around even though they should be going away. And over time, those areas grow and cause cancer. What we're learning, and what we know already, is there are several things that predispose us to cancer. And West Virginia is the second highest new cancer state and has the third highest death rate in cancer, but it's really leaning toward cancers like lung cancer, which is caused by smoking. And we have made progress in this state, but having a reduction in the number of people smoking will be one of the most important interventions that we can possibly make in the future health and the prevention of cancer. And that's what the screening programs have been championed by the Cancer Institute are doing. As we go forward though, we know now today that the immune system, our infection fighting system, is also really important in removing cancer cells from our system. And cancer cells are really, really quite sly, and they figure out ways to avoid the immune system, and there are clinical trials now that can augment the immune system so that they remove cancer cells without hurting us, and we also have clinical trials where we can cause the cancer cells to not be so sly anymore, and we can expose them so that the immune cells that we have can remove them. And being part of these kind of clinical trials where we can do things very specifically against the genetics that may have altered in those cells to augment our immune systems to remove those cells, or to unmask the cancer cells to allow their normal removal, are really what we are talking about, and bringing that to Princeton, and bringing that to Welch, and bringing that to all parts of the state in a way, as President Key said, where it's not just about writing a paper or getting a grant that serves us, it's about creating solutions that serve the great people in our state. Mother Teresa said, "Don't count numbers, help every person. and start with the person closest to you. That is what we're doing today. We're starting with the people closest to us in Princeton. And we want to bring the best of all cancer care to our people. And by doing that, we help provide our beautiful state and beautiful people with beautiful and well lives. Thank you.
Well said, Dr. Marson. Thank you very much. Okay, well, we will save the best for last. Our the architect of our WVU Cancer Institute and our journey to NCI designation is Dr. Hazard Jenkins. Dr. Hazard is a fellowship-trained breast surgeon by background. She is a native West Virginian, born in Morgantown, grew up in Martinsburg, and then Charleston, and then the medical school, and then Morgantown now. So she, and I've been working with Hannah for 9 years now. Hannah understands the state of West Virginia, she understands cancer, and she is the perfect individual to lead us on the journey that we're about to go on. Dr. Hannah has a
lot shorter. I'll be honest, this is pretty humbling and pretty surreal sitting here thinking about the commitment from the state and what we're embarking on, which is really a continuation of what everybody who takes care of patients with cancer is doing on a day-to-day basis. So, as Alba says, born and raised here. I've actually tried to flee the state twice and was profoundly unsuccessful. And it's a great privilege to sit here and stand before you to represent that Cancer Institute. This generous contribution represents an immense leap forward in our understanding of how cancer happens, how we treat it, and really to get to the root of the matter, how we prevent it, because that's our ultimate goal. The governor, thank you, and our state legislature behind this incredible donation. It's really going to be able to catapult us, and we're humbled by your compassion and your dedication towards our fight against cancer. The impact of this can't be overstated. There's nothing about this that isn't monumental, and it allows us to embark upon groundbreaking research, be able to look at innovative ways to deliver cancer care across the state. We've all traveled the state, we're from the state. The socioeconomic factors are definitely part of our incidence, part of our outcomes, but they're not the only factors. And so by building a Cancer Institute dedicated to West Virginia, to Appalachia, our goal is to not only treat, but then figure out what's unique about us that allows us to target our population very specifically. This donation will strengthen our ability to make those strides in prevention, early detection, and personalized therapies. The clinical trials that you've heard all of us mention are vitally important. As a breast surgeon, there isn't a single operation I do that isn't born out of a clinical trial, even starting in the 1970s. And so the best way that we can get the most advanced care to patients is through clinical trials. And having access to that in places other than Morgantown is incredibly important when we think about having our survivors move through the state. I would be pretty remiss if I didn't express my gratitude and thanks to all of the healthcare professionals, researchers, support staff, volunteers that take care of our patients on a day-to-day basis all across the state. Their dedication, their compassion, and expertise are really the foundation of cancer care and what allows us to be able to help our patients live the lives that they need to be living. To the patients and their families, probably even more important to the caregivers, is to thank them for entrusting their care to us. So I meet a patient, she knows me for 45 minutes, but within 30 seconds, she's giving me information that is very personal, very profound. And that's a very humbling thing and should always be humbling. And the fact that they're trusting us as an institution and as a is a tremendous thing. So together we look forward to moving cancer care, cancer delivery, and prevention forward in this state through a multitude of avenues. And with the generous gift from the governor and the state, we'll make that happen much faster. Thank you very much.
justice and the state legislators and our legislators here, because of your great vision, this transformational day and event has occurred, and 100% I have confidence that this will improve the health care of West Virginia. Thank you for being here today. Thank you, Governor. I believe we have refreshments. I believe we have blue and gold bow tie cookies. I don't know if we have any blue and gold doggone cookies, but we'll have to check that out. But thank you, everyone, for being here. Again, Governor Justice, thank you so much.